So in this question, we're asked to verify Gauss's divergence theorem for the following surfaces and vector fields. So to verify Gauss's divergence theorem, we need to show that the left-hand side, the flux, so the surface integral of f dotted with the unit normal, integrated over the surface, is equal to the volume integral of the divergence of the vector field, integrated over the volume. Okay, so in order to verify it, we need to show that the left-hand side is equal to the right-hand side. Okay, so let's look at our surface given here. Z is equal to 2 minus square root of x squared plus y squared. Okay, so that's my x, that's my z, that's my y. Alright, so this is a cone. Okay, you need to know that that's a cone. And the key indication is that it's z equals square root of x squared plus y squared, or proportional to the square root. Because if I let x equals 0, so I'm on the zy plane, so I want to know the equation of this line here, I can see that it's going to be z is equal to 2 minus the square root of just y squared. Square root of y squared is just y, so it's going to be z is equal to 2 minus y. Okay? So you can see it's straight lines, and it will be the same on the zx plane if you let y equals 0. If you let z equals 0, I have 2 is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. So that means this is the equation of a circle, x squared plus y squared is equal to 4. Okay? And we're only interested in the region on the xy plane, my region A, because that will give me my integral on the left hand side. So we're going to calculate the left hand side first. We're going to show that that equals something, and then we're going to do that integral separately, and hopefully they're going to equal each other. So the region A, we need to define as our limits. So it's clearly a circle, so we're going to need polar coordinates. So R and theta are going to be our limits. Okay, so the radius is the square root of 4, which is 2. So it goes out to 2. So R is between 2 and 0, and theta goes all the way around from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so we've done that. Next thing we need to do, so we've got our limits. Next thing we need to do is find n. Remember, n's our unit normal to the surface. Just our normal to the surface. Because this integral is equivalent to the area integral, so the, over the region A on the xy plane, f dotted with n dA, because the grad f cancels out. We looked at that in the previous video, okay? So we just need to find n, which is equal to grad f. And f is equal to, we bring all the z's, x and y's on one side, so it's z plus the square root of x squared plus y squared. Okay, so grad f is going to be equal to, got to be careful when taking the derivative here, it's going to be x on the square root of x squared plus y squared, y on the square root of x squared plus y squared, and 1. So remember, we just got to check that we've got the positive outward unit, positive outward normal, and this is positive 1, hence we do, otherwise we'd have to times this by negative 1. So now we're ready to find f dotted with grad f, or f dotted with n. Remember, this is equal to n. So f is equal to negative y x z, and our normal is equal to x on the square root of x squared plus y squared, y on the square root of x squared plus y squared, and 1. So it's equal to negative xy on the square root of x squared plus y squared plus x times y on the square root of x squared plus y squared plus z. Okay? Fortunately, these two things will cancel out. I've got a negative and a positive of the same thing. So it's just going to be equal to z. So f dotted with n is equal to z. So now I'm ready to find my flux. So the flux. So I'll just choose a bit of a brighter color. Okay, so the flux is equal to, just to remind you, AF dotted with MDA, which is equal to, so my A is these limits for R and theta, so 0 to 2 pi, 0 to 2, F dotted with N, which is Z, and DA, which is R, dr, d theta. Don't forget the Jacobian. But what's Z? Well, Z's given to us by the surface, 2 minus square root x squared plus y squared. So this is equal to 2 pi to 0, 2 to 0, 2 minus the square root of x squared plus y squared times r, d theta. Okay, but what's x squared plus y squared? Well, we get that from the change of coordinates here. Remember, we made the change of coordinates to polar, so x is equal to r cos theta, and y is equal to r sine theta. And x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Whoops. Okay, so you remember that result. You can prove it for yourself, but it's easier just to remember the fact that x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. So this integral is going to become 0 to 2 pi, 0 to 2, 2 times r, minus the square root of r squared, times r, d theta. Okay, expanding out the brackets. So the square root of r squared is just r. So I've got 2 pi to 0, 2 to 0, 2r minus r squared, dr, d theta. Pretty simple integral. Let's find it. 0 to 2 pi. R squared minus a third r cubed from r equals 2 to r equals 0 d theta, so equal 0 to 2 pi. R squared when r is equal to 2 is 4 minus 8 on 3, and the zeros are just going to give me 0. So 4 minus 8 on 3, well, 4 times 3 is 12 minus 8 is 4, so it's 4 thirds. So 0 to 2 pi, 4 on 3 d theta, which is equal to 4 theta on 3, from theta equals 2 pi, theta equals 0, which is equal to 8 pi on 3. Okay, so the flux integral, or the left hand side, we've shown is equal to 8 pi on 3. Okay, so now let's go over here and work out the right-hand side. The right-hand side. And we'll see, it might be a lot easier to work it out. Okay, so we need to find the divergence of F. Okay, we always do that first because it could be zero. So we don't even have to waste time finding our parameters for V. Okay, so grad dot F is grad of negative YXZ. So remember, grad is day X, day Y, day Z. So this is just partial derivative with respect to x, partial derivative with respect to y, partial derivative with respect to z. It's a really neat way of writing it. Okay, so partial derivative of y with respect to x is 0. Partial derivative of x with respect to y is also 0. And the partial derivative of z with respect to z is 1. So grad dot f is 1. So now I need to find my volume v that makes up this cone over here. Okay, so we're going to need a change of coordinates, and we're going to need cylindrical. Okay, so it's a 3D change of coordinates. So we've got cylindrical or spherical, and it's not a sphere, it's a cone, so it's cylindrical. Okay, spherical coordinates we only use if it's a sphere, and we'll see an example of that in a bit. So for cylindrical coordinates, I need to get my limits on r, my limits on theta, and my limits on z. Okay, so r is going to be the same. We get that from the xy plane, so 0 to 2. Theta is going to be all the way around, 0 to 2 pi. We're going all the way around the xy plane. And z is going to be, remember with z, we go from the negative z direction to the positive. Okay, so what function do we hit first, and what function do we hit second? So in terms of z, the function we hit first is the xy plane, or the plane z equals 0. And the second function we hit is not a plane, but the surface itself, which is 2 minus the square root of x squared plus y squared. That's the upper bound on z. It has variable limits. Okay, so fortunately, we can now write the volume integral. Volume of the divergence of f dv is going to be equal from 0 to 2 pi, 0 to 2, and 0 to 2 minus square root of x squared plus y squared, but x squared plus y squared for cylindrical coordinates is x equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r cos theta, z is equal to z, so x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. So this is going to be 2 minus the square root of r squared, which is 2 minus r. Okay, so we have to have the divergence of the vector field, which is 1, so we can just have 1, and then we have dv, but we've made a change of coordinates, so it's dr or dz dr d theta, but don't forget the Jacobian r, so it's equal to, we can take out the d theta integral because nothing depends on theta. I could have done that before, I didn't. 2 to 0, and now I can integrate this with respect to z first, and we can't separate these two because the limits here depend on r. So it's going to be rz from z is equal to 2 minus r, and z is equal to 0 dr. So this is going to be the difference of the limits, which is 2 pi, 0 to 2, and r times that, so I'm going to get 2r minus r squared, and z's going to give me the 0, dr, which is equal to 2 pi times r squared minus a third r cubed, from r equals 2, r equals 0, which is equal to 2 pi times 2 squared is 4, minus 2 cubed is 8 on 3, 4 minus 8 on 3 is 4 on 3 times 2 is 8 pi on 3. Okay, so using the right hand side, or the volume integral of the divergence, we've also got that it's equal to 8 pi on 3. So hence we have verified Gauss's divergence theorem by working out the left hand side, then the right hand side, and showing that they're equal. And the reason why we are exploring this is because sometimes it's easier to work it out using the left hand side, and sometimes it's easier to work it out using the right hand side. And in an exam, you might not be told which side to use. You have to think about which side to use. Okay, and we'll look at an example in the next couple of videos of where you it's easy to use the right hand side. Okay, so have a go at question 2b. Have a go, it's pretty similar, and verify Gauss's divergence theorem.